today is the topic we are going to work on today is the development process and development industry. It's a very long title, as you can see. It took me half an hour to just be able to type the title. It was that big a title for this class, for this topic. It is exactly as it is mentioned in your syllabus. Oh, my webcam is not connected. Yeah. So anyway, so it is the development process and the development industry. So before we start, we need to understand the meaning. That what does it mean? That development is a process as well as an industry. That means development is something that has to be done judiciously. There is a process, there is a structure attached to development. Development cannot be just a theoretical idea that we will develop and this is the concept of development. No, it has to be an industry. Industry does not mean that, okay, Ambani has to work in that. That is not the meaning of industry. Industry means an organized process. If I ask you to define an industry, right? I mean, we know in English it is used as a word, as an adjective also, that that person was very industrious. Somebody must have probably asked, told you also sometime that to be able to crack UPSC, you have to be very industrious. The meaning of industrious is that you have to be very structured, very organized and very laborious, right? So the idea is that it is very clearly, some kind of an industry. Development is a long process which needs to have a structure. And in that process, government is not the only sector. Government is not the only player working in that sector. So government, what government does, we study that in economics. We study all of that in economics. What the government does for development, remember? We have taught about the social development, poverty, everything we have talked about. In this chapter, we'll be talking about the role of NGOs, self-help groups, various groups and associations, donors, charities, institutions, and other stakeholders. So today we will be talking about the development process and development industry and the role of the NGOs. That is the part we will be covering today, right? Though the most important part as per the UPSC trend in this is the SHGs. The self-help group is the favorite topic of UPSC, where a lot of questions have been coming. But for the paucity of time, I normally count the number of slides and I calculate the time consumed based on that. I don't think we'll be able to cover beyond the NGOs today because we have UPSC questions also to discuss. Today I'll be discussing three questions with you. All three are actual UPSC questions, right? All three are actual UPSC questions, so we need to keep time for that also. So let us move quickly, because it is going to be a slightly longish class. So let us quickly move forward. The first thing is that what exactly is development? Right? I think that is a very simple idea. We have discussed that 1,000 times in economics. Those of you who are humanities students of sociology and all that, and they know that, and half the course is all about defining development, that what exactly is development, whose development should be prioritized, how development should reach people, how do we define development. So that is okay. We are aware of that. So anyway, so first is economic development. We are aware of that. This is this is usually counted as development, right? Whenever we say that development has happened, usually we mean the economic development only, right? I mean, because the GDP number earlier was 6% and then it grew by 8% in the early 2000s. So we say that India was developing. So it was economic development only, that the size of our economy, it was growing, it was swelling. So that is the most obvious idea of development, that is economic development. Second is human development. Now, human development is a very important idea, and the most important person in this idea is Amartya Sen. Professor Amartya Sen is the most important person in the field of human development. Anywhere in the world, if you go and you talk about human development and you study in any university, you go to Harvard, you go to Oxford, wherever you want to go. If you study the human development, then you will be given the readings by Professor Amartya Sen. That is a given. Amartya Sen's reading, you are going to study for sure, right? So who will tell me what exactly is the concept of human development that has been given by Amartya Sen? Who would want to talk about that? He has written a very famous book on that. Very, very famous book. Somebody raising hand? Nobody knows anything about Amartya Sen. Naam to suna hai, nahi suna. Nobody has heard the name of Amartya. Acha, Roja. Yes, Roja. Go on, beta. Tell me. Tell me about the idea. Tell me about Amartya Sen's concept of development.
Amartya Sen's concept of development actually speaks about the freedom of human.
Very good. His book is called Development as Freedom. Very good. Those of you who have not read that book, no need to read the book. Google and read the introduction of the book. I think it's a 16-page document. These are 16 pages that will give you a lot of insights, right? It is, I mean, when I, for my foundation course students, I used to give it as an essential reading. That not read this, right? Please stop messaging me, let students in, right? It will be better if you focus on your class, right? So now the thing is, so the point, yes, Roja, carry on, beta. Carry on. Anything you want to add to that? Oh, I have to unmute you, I'm sorry. Yes, go on. Anything you want to add to that?
It's like expansion of capabilities of the citizens, actually.
Right. So what Amartya Sen says, putting a very complicated concept in a very simple way, that every citizen has a number of choices, right? So the point is that, that if I am deciding what is development for you all, so will development mean the same thing for all of you? Right. So let's say for Kalyani, the development might be something else, while for Animesh, the development's meaning might be something totally different. Right. So if I am the central authority who's deciding what is development, it is going to be a little off mark or not. Some people will be very happy. Some people will be saying, what the hell is doing? It is not development. It is not helping me at all. That is the primary argument against the kind of centralized development we go for in India anyway. That is the primary argument or not, that, oh, you are developing industries, but what about the tribals? They are getting relocated. What about them? So Amartya Sen said that it is not possible to go for this kind of centralized development. Instead, the idea of human development is that every individual has a number of choices in life, right? And development actually means that we should give more power to that individual to be able to choose which path he or she wants to take. Is it clear or not? So whether you want to study further or whether you want to work, if you want to study further, then you should have enough money and enough, I would say, availability of college, school, infrastructure for you to be able to, like, let's say if Kalyani chooses to study further, but there is no university nearby her, wherever she wants to live or she lives, then is that a proper choice? No. So the government's job is that to give her a choice, to choose for herself, whether I want to study further. If she wants to study further, government needs to establish institutes so that she can go and study, right? If she wants to work, then government needs to make sure that enough employment is available so that she can be employed, right? So whatever life choices, so the government needs to increase the number of choices for people and should build adequate structure so that people can choose what they want to do. Is it clear or not? Read that Development as Freedom's introduction. It's very important. It's a very important book, right? So please read that. So that is the fundamental concept of what Amartya Sen had taught. Then sustainable development, very, very highly used and abused term. We all know that. Remember the SDGs, sustainable development goals and all that. So the idea is that we should not just develop for this generation, but for the coming generations also. We should not consume so much that there is nothing left for the coming generation, right? And then development as a political process, right? So development should also be a political process. That means when we count the political journey of a country in years or in governments or, in the government policies, in the laws that are made, development should also be some kind of a central key point of these political processes also.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment and share the video. Subscribe to UPSC Pathshala and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Don't forget to register for our free live classes. Find the link in the description box. This is your chance to prepare yourself with personal trainers.